Hello everyone and welcome to Nag Graphics. We are doing the chapter of line segment tools, and so far we have done the line tool, arc tool and the spiral tool. Today we will discuss about the rectangular grid tool. This tool will draw a rectangular grid as I drag, as you are looking right now. Let's see how it reacts when drawn along with some keyboard keys pressed. As you drag the rectangular grid, press up or down arrow keys to increase or decrease the row segments, and press left or right arrow keys to increase or decrease the column segments. Press X or C keys to increase or decrease the skew value of the columns, and press F or V keys to increase or decrease the skew values of rows. Now, skew value means the next row or column will be bigger in size by certain percentage. For example, if skew is 50%, that would mean that next column or row will be 50% bigger than the previous one. While dragging to draw this shape, if you want to change the location of rectangle, press spacebar with your dragging mouse button still pressed and move the shape to the desired place. Press shift key while dragging to draw a perfect, equally proportioned square. Remember that your shift key should be released after you release the mouse button for making equally proportioned square. Press Alt key to draw a center outward rectangle, which means that the point from where we start dragging will become the center point of the rectangle. Press both Alt and Shift keys and then drag to draw a center outward grid with equal height and width. All these things can be done in a precise way through dialog box, which is appeared when you click once anywhere on the canvas. Point of click becomes the originating point of the rectangle. Let's discuss the options inside this dialog box. Width and height values will decide the width and the height of rectangle. Then here we have reference points. This will decide the direction of the originating point of the grid. However, I have discussed the topic of reference point and its use in very detailed manner in the lesson of arc tool. That lesson is also flashing up here over the video as tested video. You can also check that. Then you have horizontal dividers. Here you decide the desired number of columns, and this is the skew value slider. You can select the skew by sliding this slider, or you can also type the value in this box. Then you have vertical dividers. Here you decide the desired number of rows, and this is again the skew value slider. Next we have a checkbox with the option of use outside rectangle as frame. Before explaining this option, I want you to take a look on a drawn rectangular grid. This appears to be a rectangle, but actually these are individual lines dividing each other to form a rectangle. As you can see, the separate anchor points of every line segment. Even the outer frame of the rectangle is also formed with four separate lines joined together. I can pick each of these lines with direct selection tool. Now come to this option again. If I take this option, the top, bottom, left and right line segments of the grid will be replaced with a separate rectangular frame. Here you can see I have selected and can edit the outer rectangular frame. This option has got its own relevance when working on a typical assignment. Then we have fill color. This option will fill the grid with currently selected fill color. And notice that like other line segment tools, it fills inside the line only, which is too thin to be noticed. But if you have checked the above option where you have opted to draw a separate rectangle frame around the grid, and then you click to fill grid, then it will fill the full rectangle. Let's do a practical. Notice that currently my fill color is set to transparent or no color. Every time you start working with any of the line segment tools, Illustrator automatically turns the fill color to be none. So I come out of this dialog box by pressing escape key, change the fill color to be green. Now again I click once to open the rectangular grid dialog box. Now if this option is unticked, and then if I choose to fill grid, it will fill only inside the line, which is almost negligible. But if I choose this option and then choose fill grid, then the whole grid will be filled with the currently selected fill color. The resultant rectangular grid according to set values will be originated from the point of click. But here is one thing to notice. If you want to draw center outward drawn rectangular grid with dialog box, then before clicking once to open the dialog box, press Alt key. And you notice that the cursor turns like a crosshair. Now, if I click OK, then the point of click becomes the center point of this grid. So this was all about the rectangular grid. And in the next lesson, we will discuss the last line segment tool, which is the polar grid tool. Thank you so much for watching. Hit like and share this video if you find it good. And subscribe for more upcoming tutorials.